It's just another day at the office for professional weaver Laura Fry. The artist makes useful pieces of work to help people get through their day-to-day lives.
I'm always looking at the best way to create a textile that will perform a particular function, whether that's a scarf or a shawl or a tea towel or a placemat. That's my first introduction into the craft.
Since her beginnings in the mid-1970s, the weaver has experimented with different forms of technology, and with the new tools comes new responsibilities.
With the additional mechanics comes additional ability for it to go horribly awry. So not only do you have to know your craft, you also have to know your tools.
So once everything technically is ready to go, Laura is free to explore her creativity through her work.
It becomes for me a kind of working meditation, and I put my boombox on and I listen to music and I just kind of go with the flow of it.
Laura's labors of love may be functional, but they still capture her sense of originality, which is what she loves to share with people.
One of the definitions of art is that it adds beauty and grace to a life. So if I can add beauty and grace to somebody else's life, it's very deeply satisfying. It is one of the reasons I do this.
Weaving is slowly becoming a lost art due to factory production of textiles, but the younger generation is slowly becoming aware of the value of handmade cloth goods.
So it's really nice to see these 20-somethings coming into the craft and being just as excited and enthusiastic about it as I was.
Laura is still forever thankful for finding her passion at such an early age.
When I finally made it to the loom, after quitting my job, buying a new house, I sat down at a loom with a shuttle in my hand for the very first time, and I felt like I'd come home.